What's going on, guys? Mr. R725 back again with some more Red Dead Redemption. We're gonna keep going on as to what I stopped earlier. As you remember, stopped earlier, I just completed the Wes Dickens and the Seth missions. I still need to do the Irish and the Bonnie missions, so we're gonna start focusing on those. Let me just switch over real quick, and we'll get this thing kicked off. Real quick, campsite. Oh. Getting over a bit of a sickness. Change outfits. Oh, I'm not doing that one. I'll use a regular cowboy. No, I'm gonna go to the map. Irish is right down here. But let's go see what Bonnie's got to say. What's up, dude? Playing some Red Dead Redemption. Well, let's go see what Bonnie's up to. A tempest. Oh, God damn it. This sucks. This is the storm mission.
Hey, miss. I got most of the horses secure and the chicken.
Well, thank you, Amos, but it's the herd I'm worried about.
I know. They're scattered all over the valley and beyond. The weather is coming in real fast.
So what do you suggest, Amos? We leave the herd out there to be scattered by the storm and ourselves left here to die without a livelihood?
Can I help?
No, miss. If the men get caught out in that storm, they're gonna die.
And if we lose our herd, we'll all die, you stupid man.
Doesn't sound like we're left with much of a choice then. Come on, Amos. Round up your men. Let's get the herd.
Dang.
Dang. Boo.
That sky don't look
Come on, pup.
I'm starting to think somebody up there is conspiring against me. Are you a religious man?
Not in any real sense. Sometimes I tell myself things happen for a reason. Like what brought me here was fate come a calling. But nobody made my path for me.
We all need to look for answers somewhere. Some in big old books, others in big old bottles of whiskey.
Believing in some kind of divine purpose ain't gonna give me my wife and kid back. Pastor's who we are, Miss McFarland. There ain't no changing that. Faith is a luxury I can't afford.
We have two herds out grazing in different pastures. We'll need to merge them and bring them all back.
I think we can handle that.
The cows get real ornery in bad weather. It's more work, but I'll show you how to deal with them. I'm gonna save my voice for the herd. It's gonna be hard shouting over this storm.
In line, Oh, no, you fucking don't.
Let's go.
Oh, shit. We're running.
There's smoke! We have to stop the stampeding!
Okay, how do we do that?
Oh, my God! They're running for the cliff!
Yeah! Let's go!
Oh shit. Nope, they're gonna run off the cliff.
Whoa there.
Well, they're dumb. They deserve to die. Trying to get them all back together, you fuck. Fucking Jesus, come on. Oh, fuck's sake. Waiting for these dumb fucking cows to get back in a fucking formation. Fucking God, dude. Stop. Go. Dumb fucking cunts. Go. Dumb bastards. No, come on. Oh my God, stop, dude. Come on. Get in fucking line, dude.
Hurry! We gotta move that bird!
Let's go! Slow
make a decent rancher one day.
Thank you, Miss McFarlane.
The burning. It's the burning.
Excuse me, Mr. Marston. Have you seen my father anywhere?
No.
He went out this morning to ride the land and was supposed to be back hours ago. I don't know. The ranch hands have been out looking, but so far they found nothing.
Well, come on. Let's go look for him.
Thank you. I'm sure it's nothing, but I worry about the old fool.
Come on.
Feeling about this. It's not like him to be away for so long.
Don't worry. We'll find him.
He's not as young as he used to be. What if he's hurt himself?
Your father can still handle himself just fine, Miss McFarlane. He's built like an oak.
You're probably right, but I can't help worrying. He's all I've got.
Don't you have any...
Hey, how's it going, viewer?
Sisters, Miss McFarlane?
I had six brothers, but five of them died, either from sickness or foolish choices.
And the other one?
He left for the East and never came back. Must be getting on for 10 years ago now. He's a high and mighty banker in New York, according to his last letter.
He should be here, helping you and your paw.
I don't want his help. He can live his life any way he wants. But when I see those city fellers coming in on the railway, all dressed up like a sore toe, I fear a little for his soul. He switched his saddle for a tie, and that's fine. I just never met a man in a tie I could trust. Look, I think I see someone. Yeah. Stay with me. Quick as you can. Daddy, what happened?
Nothing nice. Wrestlers, I guess. Maybe the Baller twins, that bunch. Now you head back to the ranch right now and fetch your wagon.
Yes, sir.
Marston, you watch after her.
I'll do that, sir.
Please stay close. Careful! What could have happened to those poor men? And their horses were dead, too.
I think we should get back there as soon as we can.
Who could have done something like that?
Your boss seemed to have an idea who it was. Let's just do what he says and get the wagon.
Come on, come on.
Those damn rustlers! I've got a good mind to head over to Pike's Basin myself.
I don't think that's a good idea.
And you're no better. How many men have you killed?
Do you really want to know?
It's disgusting.
You never met the men I killed.
I heard the way you talk about that gang you were in. Like there was some twisted morality to what you did.
We all have a code. Only some of us don't realize.
The outlaw with the code? How wonderfully romantic. The reluctant murderer, the noble criminal. There's nothing more depressing than a man who's found a way to think the bad into good.
You're upset, Miss...
Look, Mr. Marston, the barn is on fire! Come on, boy!
What the shit?
They're trapped in there!
There ain't enough of us! This ain't working! Help me, will
There's
you?
No way in through the front!
On. We gotta get to the horse!
Try and get in through the loft, Mr. Marston. Climb up the windmill.
Mazawa. What?
Somebody get them horses out.
Oh.
Put it out.
Hold the door.
Los caballos.
I like how they introduce this mechanic and then never use it again. Come on now.
Thanks, Marston.
Yes, John, thanks. You, well, you saved the ranch.
If you'll excuse me, I've got chores to attend to. Hey, hold on a second over there.
Sincerely, John. Thank you.
Well, I did all I could, Miss McFarlane. Sorry about all the damage. That gang seems to really want you out of here.
Yeah, well, my father fought Indians. I scarcely think we're gonna be frightened by some white trash.
White trash can be pretty frightening.
Well, they don't frighten me.
Good.
John, my family owes you a great debt.
I think you got enough debt. You saved my life. All I ask of you is this. If I get back home and get my farm started back up, you'll sell me some cattle. I prefer doing business with people I know.
Of course, Mr. Marston. It'd be my pleasure. Well, you get some rest. I've got to go see how my father's bearing up.
$160. What's up? Oh, whoops. Come on. Yo, I'm already out here.
I don't have a clue. All right, but it's got to be something to do with that government boy.
We'll talk to him, find out what he knows.
Fucking is. Where is she, Marston?
Who?
Who? My daughter, you fucking scum. Where's Bonnie?
I don't know. I haven't seen her since after the fire. Why?
Why? Because she hadn't been seen since yesterday afternoon. You know, I don't think I can cope. If I lose another child...
Now, Drew, nobody's lost anything yet. I'm sure she's fine.
Oh, Mr. Marshall! Mr. Marshall! Come out, wherever you are!
Who the hell's that?
Hey, buddy! That'd be your next fucking mayor.
Even better! Good day, Mr. McFarland!
Get down from that horse, boy, or I'll shoot.
I wouldn't recommend that, mister. Not if Drew McFarland wants to see his bony back in one piece. Hey, Mr. McFarland! It's a nice girl you got there.
Get out from there!
You know, part of me's got to thinking I should just marry her myself. Give her a baby and that.
What do you want?
That's better. I want Norman Deke. I want him set free. Then you'll get your daughter back, mister.
We don't do deals with outlaws, boy.
Yeah, you do! Let's not waste each other's time pretending otherwise. Oh, government themselves ain't much more than a bunch of crooks. This is the land of opportunity, mister. And I'm giving you the opportunity to get your daughter back before 15 friends of mine take out all their anger and their loneliness on her.
Where the hell is she?
Where is she, boy?
Bring Deke up to Tumbleweed in a couple hours. And don't get no funny ideas, or I will slit that horse's throat myself. You boys have a pleasant afternoon. Yeah!
What do we do?
We do as he says. You and me, Marshal. Mr. McFarland, I'll get you your daughter back. I owe her that.
Please do.
I'll teach you some respect for the law. Hurry up, boy. Let's go. Quick as you can, deputy. Make sure he's tied on good.
All right.
Stay with me, Marston.
I won't let anything happen to her, sir.
Yeah.
Let's go.
1 second, guys.
Let's go get Miss McFarland back. See, this is what happens when the Federals interfere in our affairs. Are you happy now?
No, I ain't happy at all. And I already told you, I ain't with the government.
Now you say that, John, but the only thing I know...
Wait a minute. You had me go after D.
They made me come here. They gave me no choice. That's your federal government, Mr. Johnson.
They come down here dressed as cocky as the King of Diamonds, talking a lot of flannel about helping us, about spreading peace and civilization to the West, but they brought nothing but trouble and taxes.
I agree with you. Wolves in sheep clothing, all of them. Rob you, then make you pay to have someone investigate the crime on your behalf.
People around here have been fooled into feeling protected when they're worse off than they were before.
Yep.
The fellas I know don't care about people. All they care about is lining their pockets.
Come on.
Why is this sorry son of a bitch so important to them?
Norman Deke's Williamson's right-hand man. In other words, a glorified errand boy.
You wait, Marshal. I'll be back for you.
Bill's standards have slipped.
We already filled you with lead once, you ugly bastard!
That's the kind of man who's mean enough to be second in command, but too cowardly and stupid to ever be a leader.
Don't ever use that line near your deputies. You know, for his sake, they'd best not have laid a finger on Miss McFarland. What is this place we're headed?
Tumbleweed, a lonely, godforsaken place. Some people say it's haunted. It was quite a town back in its day. Then they built the railroad to Armadillo and went clean past Tumbleweed. That was that. Pretty soon, everybody had up and left. Now it's just thieves, smugglers, and bandits. Scum like Deke here. Oh, popular spot for lynchings, too.
Let's try to avoid that if we can, Marshal.
I just hope you're not taking advantage of the McFarland, Marston.
They saved my life! Gave me food and bed when they had no idea who I was.
Hey, how's it going, viewer?
More than I can ever repay.
That's just they've been through a lot. Well, they're both vulnerable, different ways.
I wouldn't have been running in and out of a burning barn to save their horses otherwise.
I know you helped, just like you helped me. But you got your reasons for doing it.
It's no secret why I'm here, Marshal. I told you the very first time I walked into your office.
I trust you. It's just all this business with Blackwater and Williamson and the past. I don't know. Sometimes it's hard not to have doubts.
I understand. I never planned to be in the lawman business, neither.
How is it supposed to turn out? Sending an outlaw to do the work of a lawman. That's madness.
Ain't much different.
Where the fuck am I going? Okay, not up.
Between the two, as far as I can tell.
There have to be rules, Marston. Even you must understand that.
It's easy to make up rules, but they ain't much use if people don't understand why. Like my son, if I tell him not to do something, he'll do it anyways, just to spite me. If I punish him, he resents me for it. But if I show him why it's wrong, at least he has reason not to do it again.
That's nonsense. Without laws, we're nothing more than animals. Just look at Deke here.
Go to hell!
Man has worked hard
for
civilization. Your boy steps out of line, you whack him. He does it again, whack him harder.
You're a good man, Marshal, and I respect what you're trying to do. From what I've seen since I've arrived here, the law ain't really working.
Criminals are like weeds, Marston. Quick as you stomp one out, another one sprouts up in its place. It's the nature of places. You know that as well as I do.
Don't worry, my boys know how to treat a lady. I'll kill all three of you myself, I swear!
There's four of us.
You think you're a man, do you?
Across the bridge! Not far to go now!
Easy there.
John, you'll be exchanging the prisoner for Bonnie in the middle of town. Keep your eyes open. I sincerely doubt these scum plan to play fair.
Fair my ass.
You bet. Besides, Norm here is going to be my shield, ain't you, Norm?
It'd be my pleasure.
Marston, lead Deke into town. Make sure you keep a gun on that son of a bitch.
I'm sure it's been nice for the boys to have a whore to play with. I hear those rancher girls like it in the rig. Maybe she won't want to go home. She's been fucked so good. What are you waiting for? Untie me, fillers!
Where's Bonnie? I thought we had a deal.
Well, you thought wrong. We don't make deals.
My God!
What the hell is this?
Find Bonnie!
Jesus, what?
What? Return to Bonnie.
I won't let you die, Bonnie!
Hold on.
What the hell?
There's money to be made. Okay, Earthbound. Hit me up when you're ready.
Are you okay?
I'll probably switch over and...
I'm fine now, Mr. Morrison. Thank you. Thank you. What the hell took you so long, you stupid man?
Well, you weren't exactly helping me.
If you think I'm gonna lower myself by making a joke about being all tied up, you got another thing coming. Come on.
I'm a buckaroo. And I think this takes me too close to where I need to be for Irish. Yes, it does. So we're just gonna ride down to where Irish is. I've been playing that Ghost Recon beta. I don't know how I feel about it, dude. It's alright, but it's not like my favorite thing. I got the HTI sniper rifle in that beta already, and that was pretty cool.
Whoa there. We all have problems, and we must solve them together, or we die alone.
Yeah, I did. I played some last night with some buddies of mine. I played on the closed beta too, before it was the open beta. Pretty fun. Don't really know how. Like I said, don't really know how I feel on it. It's fun, but it doesn't really have like the replayability. If you ask me, like it's pretty open world, and that's cool. But the storyline's not really enough to draw me in so far. But we'll get you through it. I need to do the story missions anyway. I did a lot of side missions and running around, so we'll do the story missions together, and I'll do it on a stream. Hitch my horse. He told me to take father's college fund and use it to buy land out here with him. Save your hot air. I could have guessed that myself. I don't give a shit about newspapers. A man is born unto trouble.
Who do you want? I see you. Get away from me.
Right here. Where's that machine gun, Irish?
Oh, Mr. Marston. I found you one.
Found us one, Irish. We're in this together. You, me, and an assault on Fort Mercer. I'm the guy that saved you from getting killed back there. And who you owe your life to, remember?
Not really. Happens to me all the time.
You don't want it to happen to you again, do you, Irish?
No, friend. I wants to buy you a drink. I wants to tell you how much you means to me, how special you is.
And I want to tell you that if you don't produce a Gatling gun within the hour, you'll wish you'd been killed back there.
It's the whiskey, sir. It gives me the memory of a newborn babe, as innocent as can be.
And it makes me violently angry. Shall we go look for that gun, sir?
Yes. Let's do that.
Not a feller to give up easily, are you?
What's going on, viewers? In a minute here, I'm going to be switching over once Earthbound's done doing whatever he's doing.
You're
not going to pass out on me, are you, Irish?
Me? No, I'm right as rain. Or at least somewhere stuck between fair and meddling.
Well, you're going to be stuck somewhere between dying and dead if you try to cross me again.
It weren't like that at all, feller. Me intentions were pure. I swear it on me poor mother.
All right, hang on, guys. This is going to sound stupid, but my wife is gone, and I just sent her pictures of our dog. So give me 1 second. All right, I'm back.
I just get a tad confused from time to time. Honest mistake.
If there's any more confusion, I'll finish what your friends in Armadillo started.
Jesus, you're an impatient bastard, aren't you?
Irish.
I hear some miners been blabbing about a machine gun they found. Apparently, they got it stashed up at Gaptooth Breach.
What do miners want with a machine gun?
Shooting at somebody, I suppose. Or selling. Oh, never been down a mine in all my life.
Sounds real fishy to me, Irish. I've just about had it with you and your game. You and Wes Dickens are so crooked, you can swallow nails and spit out.
I love this game. There's one line where he goes, he's like, you know, these miners have this machine gun stashed up at Gaptooth Breach. Like, what do miners want a machine gun for? I don't know. Shoot it at somebody, I suppose. Or sell it? I don't know. I've never been down to me a mine all my life.
You repaid me by lying, nearly getting me killed.
Not fair now, Johnny. We should go around the side of Gaptooth so the miners don't see us coming.
I still don't know what miners would want with a machine gun.
Miners are always fighty bastards. Spend too long without daylight and doxies, and it starts playing with your mind.
I never heard so much shit come out of one mouth.
Only telling you what I heard. Oh, and we'll need a wagon or something to get it out of there. That gun's heavier than sin.
So how was I supposed to move it by myself last time? Two-faced little bastard.
Easy there. Here we are. Let's stop here a moment to get the lie of the land.
Well, stop jerking it and watch something else. I don't know why you're jerking it to my stream. That's a little weird, dude.
The entrance is plain to see, and there's a shaft them bastards use to haul out heavy ore. You, can use that lift to get you and the gun to the surface. I do it all myself, but the mines play havoc with me sinuses. I'll find us a fine place to hide these horses, and then return with a borrowed flat wagon.
I'll meet you at the mouth of the mine shaft. And Irish, I strongly advise you don't run off this time.
You're trespassing. State your business or move along.
Now what are you gonna do? Let's see what you got.
Stand by. You want a second. Did you join? What's going on? Yeah, what's up?
I can hear myself on your stream. I feel fucking famous.
Well, you shouldn't, because you suck.
Listen. I can hear myself on your stream. I feel fucking famous.
That guy's fucking dead. I just ruined that guy's life.
I'm so happy that they added that to the game. Or to the
Xbox
streaming shit.
Well, you know it was on PS4, like, since the PS4 Twitch app came out, right?
Yeah, but the Xbox blows cocks, so...
Oh, I mean, yeah. But I still like it, though. Because it's got Rainbow Six Siege, and I like Rainbow Six Siege. PS4 does, too, but doesn't have competitive.
Oh, it doesn't?
No. I mean, it does in the sense that it's got, like, the game battle shit, but it doesn't have, like, actual ESL. Dumb bastard.
I wish I could stream.
Why can't you stream?
It's fucking... It's shitty and... I have
shitty
internet.
Oh, it's laggy as fuck? Yeah.
Yeah. I really miss doing it, but...
I pay for that good.
Alright.
Give me a... just do what you gotta do. Have you done the first mission yet or no?
I don't know.
All right, well, let me finish up this mission real quick on my stream. If you want to watch it, cool. If you don't, you can fuck off or hang out. I don't know.
I'm gonna jerk it again.
Well, you got 2 minutes. You should be able to jerk it at least 4 more times.
4? You need to pump those numbers up.
Well, I'm sorry. I don't have a hair trigger like you do.
I respond to texts a lot with, like, ha 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 and lol and shit.
Yeah.
And one person was like, why are you always laughing? And I was like, because I'm crippled inside.
Because I'm dead inside. I hung out with a friend today. That was actually really nice. I had a pretty good day today.
What'd you do today?
I hung out with a friend. Like, just... She and I just hung out and watched that OJ show on Netflix and ate Chinese food.
Oh, yeah? Is it good?
Yeah, it's pretty fucking good. It's got a fucking great cast. It's got Cuba Gooding Jr. It's got John Travolta. It's got, Kevin James is in it. There's a couple other people. There's some actual people in it. Like, actual pretty good people in it. It's pretty goddamn good. David Schwimmer's in it.
Yeah, the lady David, was talking about that.
David, fucking, Captain Sobel, or his name from fucking Band of Brothers.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah. I think that was David Schwimmer, wasn't it? Yeah, it was David Schwimmer.
I do like the sniping on this game.
It's very pretty satisfying. Dope. I'll have to try to find it later, but I found the HTI sniper rifle, which is essentially the 50 cal, and it does have a suppressor.
Ooh.
Yeah, I was using it to fucking ruin people's lives.
I'll invite you whenever you're ready. I'm kind of just chilling.
Let me just finish this mission real quick. I gotta push this minecart out of this fucking mine.
I am so happy that, like, the undercut thing became, like, a mainstream thing, because now I can get it on all my characters in my games.
I did the undercut with the lumberjack beard.
Look like a fuckboy all the time. I got the shorter beard.
You got the business beard?
Yeah, just because, you know... Beards? I mean, I don't grow beards, so I can't really speak them.
Well, I haven't shown you. I've been slowly growing my beard out.
I can't grow a beard.
Mine's still really scraggly, but I've got the stuff on. I've got the stuff on the look at ordering called Grave. It's called Grave Before Shave. And supposedly it like promotes natural healthy beard growth. And I was part of this group that was talking about it and shit like that. I was fucking just talking about different shit. I'm like, how do you guys grow your beard? Like, I don't understand. Like, am I just cursed to always have a fucking shitty little, you know, shitty little scruffy beard? And they're like, no, like one guy's like, no, dude. He's like, I fucking used to have this really bad fucking scruffy beard. It was all patchy and shit. I started using this Grave Before Shave shit, and it works really well. It's just expensive as fuck. Like a 4-ounce bottle is like fucking $25.
If it gets me to grow a fucking beard, I don't care how expensive it is.
Right?
One of my friends has the same profile picture as me. I'm gonna have to delete them.
Like the
gamertag picture.
Yeah.
Paul the polar bear. I'm gonna have to delete him because that's.
What happens if I chose that one?
Well, you fucking bye bye then, bitch.
No, you wouldn't get rid of me. You need me.
Oh, cool. They have like longest shot stats and stuff.
Yeah. Mine's at like 386 meters right now, I think.
What did I tell you? I really like the sniping in this game, so I fuck around with the sniper rifle a whole lot.
Oh, yeah, so do I.
Longest shot, 488 meters.
Nice.
With my long dick. It's really.
Are you still using the M40?
Yeah. Like I said, I played fucking. Actually, it says how long I played right here. Just make sure it doesn't fall off on the way. 5 minutes. 7 minutes. All right.
Okay. Well, I just finished up this.
Ooh,
so.
Boy. Ooh, boy.
Which says just saving.
You
Alright, I'm gonna hop off my stream real quick and then I'll jump on. Alright, guys, see you guys in a couple minutes. I'm gonna switch over to Ghost Recon Wildlands. Give me 1 second, alright?